Hello world. I'm Imagination. In this video, I'm going to talk about China's plans to complete the space station by 2022. After the successful maiden flight of the Long March 5B large rocket and the testing of China's new generation manned spaceship, more details of China's space station have been unveiled. The space station, expected to be completed around 2022, will operate in the low Earth orbit at an altitude from 340 kilometers to 450 kilometers for more than 10 years, supporting large-scale scientific, technological, and application experiments, according to a report in the People's Daily. The space station Tiangong, meaning Heavenly Palace, will be able to accommodate 3 astronauts in normal circumstances and up to 6 during a crew replacement. The station will be a T-shape with the core module at the center and a lab capsule on each side. Each of the modules will be over 20 tons, with the total mass of the station about 66 tons, said Zhou Jianping, chief designer of China's manned space program. If China's Tiangong 1 and Tiangong 2 space labs are like one-bedroom apartments, the space station is equivalent to an apartment with 3 bedrooms, a living room, a dining room, and a storage room, said Zhu Guangqing, deputy chief designer of the space station from China Academy of Space Technology. The first lab capsule, named Wenxian, will be mainly used for scientific and technological experiments, as well as working and living space and shelter in an emergency. This capsule is equipped with a special airlock chamber to support extravehicular activities and a small mechanical arm for automatic installation and operation of extravehicular instruments. It possesses some key functions of the core module, which means it can perform the management and control of the space station if needed, according to the China Academy of Space Technology. The second lab capsule, named Mengxian, has functions similar to the first lab capsule. It is equipped with a special airlock chamber to support the entry and exit of cargo and instruments, with the help of astronauts and mechanical arms. The Long March 2F carrier rocket and Shenzhou manned spacecraft will be used to transport crew and some materials between Earth and the space station. The Shenzhou can carry 3 astronauts and be used as a rescue spacecraft in an emergency. The Long March 7 rocket and Tianzhou cargo spacecraft will be used to transport materials, propellants, and instruments for the station. The Long March 5B rocket will carry into space the core module and lab capsules, as well as a capsule holding a 2-meter caliber optical telescope, which will fly in the same orbit as the space station. The telescope capsule, named Shenzhou, is expected to provide observation data for astronomical and physical studies to help scientists better understand the universe. During its expected 10-year operation, it will be able to observe over 40% of the sky, said Zhu. The capsule can dock with the space station for maintenance and refueling. China's space station can be expanded and upgraded according to research needs and will give full play to the role of people in space, said Zhu. 12 flight missions are planned to construct the station. After the maiden flight of the Long March 5B, the core module and the 2 lab capsules will be launched for assembly in orbit. 4 manned and 4 cargo craft will also be launched, said Lin Zikang, deputy director of the China Manned Space Agency. China will face great challenges and complexities in the coming high-density launch missions, said Zhou Jianping. Chinese astronauts will shoulder many tasks in the construction of the space station. They will conduct many complex extravehicular tasks and work with mechanical arms to complete the installation, testing, adjustment, and upgrading of the payloads in orbit. One astronaut can operate the mechanical arm inside the capsule while another works outside. The space station will have 2 kinds of mechanical arms, and the cooperation between astronauts and mechanical arms will enable the construction and maintenance of the station, said Zhu. Because of the high cost of transporting materials into space, the ability to recycle as much as possible is a major technological issue, Zhu said. The longest stay in space so far by Chinese astronauts is 33 days. The water and oxygen they needed were taken into space. To enable astronauts to stay longer, the station will be equipped with a renewable life support system. The hydrogen produced in electrolytic oxygen production and the carbon dioxide exhaled by astronauts can generate oxygen through a chemical reaction, which can supplement oxygen for the space station. The power system includes 2 pairs of flexible solar panels, with each panel about 30 meters long. The station will also use electric propulsion technology to maintain its course. Science facilities on the station could support hundreds of research projects in fields such as astronomy, space life science, biotechnology, microgravity, basic physics, and space materials. More than a dozen advanced experiment tracks will be installed, and an extravehicular experiment platform will be built. Each rack is regarded as a lab that can support various space experiments. Scientists will also conduct space life science and biotechnology experiments on the station to study how human beings might live in space for long periods. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.